Good morning, students. Today we are going to see Standard 5th, Chapter number 7, From Shelters to Village Settlements. In previous period, we had seen 7.1, Shelter. Today we are going to see 7.2, Seasonal Camps. In the Middle Stone Age, groups of Homo sapiens had established camps all over the world. At that time, the climate was getting warmer. Everywhere, the environment was changing, and with it, the diet of Homo sapiens was also undergoing change. So, according to the seasonal camps, in it, they had given that the Middle Stone Age groups of Homo sapiens, they had established camps in all over the part of the world. Also, as according to the change in climate, they had started moving from one place to another places. With it, they had changed their diet. So, Homo sapiens had been made change according to the change in environment. By the time of Middle Stone Age, big animals like mammoths were on the way to extinction due to changing environment, and also because they were hunted on a very large scale. That is why Homo sapiens had largely turned to fishing. He also began to depend more on hunting smaller animals like the wild boar, deer, mountain goat, and sheep. Here, under this paragraph, we can come to know that the Middle Stone Age people, as like big animals like mammoths, were on the way of extinction due to hunting of the mammoth and also by the change in environment, which has resulted in the extinction of the mammoth. They also turned and to hunt smaller animals like the wild boar, deer, mountain goat, and sheep. The changed diet pattern enabled the groups of Homo sapiens to roam to faraway regions. They moved their camps to different places according to seasonal changes. So, as according to their diet pattern, the Homo sapiens have to move and they have to roam from one place to another places, and they have to go faraway regions to collect food, due to which they have time to time they have to change their places from one place to another places according to seasonal changes. There, they harvested seasonal wild grains and gathered seasonal fruits and roots. So as what? As according to change in season, according to the seasons, they had started growing grains and different seasonal fruits and roots as their diet part. They would find out the best season for fishing and use the knowledge to their advantage. So, as according to the season, they had started fishing, and according to their knowledge, they had improved, the development of their skills had been improved, and the fishing activity had carried in a large amount. By observation, they discovered the best hunting grounds. For these reasons, they stayed in one place for longer period. They cleared jungles by felling trees and set up their seasonal camps in the clearings. So, according to the situation, as they had started moving from one place to another places for hunting and for gathering food, it had been resulted to settle the camps at different places. So, they had started cutting the jungles and by felling the trees and set up their seasonal camps at that clearings. So, here they had given the picture, a reconstruction of a village settlement of New Stone Age they had given. You can see, which is given on page number 31, also on screen I'm showing you. Here another picture they had given, a reconstruction of a seasonal camp of Middle Stone Age. The difference you can see here, they are totally dependent on the environment. Fruits or to grow agriculture production, and different settled houses also we can see. It means that by clearing the forest, they had settled at one place, and by agriculture process, they had started settling at one place without moving from one place to another places. Village settlements. The way of life of humans in the New Stone Age was completely different from that of humans in the Old Stone Age and Middle Stone Age. During this period, humans became producers of food grains. As the way of human life in the New Stone Age has been changed, they are completely different from that humans of Old Stone Age and Middle Stone Age. During this period, human becomes producers of food grains. It means that they had been skilled in producing food grains by doing agriculture production. The beginning of cultivation is a characteristic of the culture of the New Stone Age. In the hunting and gathering way of life, it is necessary to keep moving all the time. As previously, before the New Stone Age, the people, the Homo sapiens, were continuously hunting and gathering their food by wandering from one place to another places, from one forest to other forest. But in New Stone Age period, the village settlement had resulted due to agriculture production. And at by one place only, by settling at one place, they had started hunting and gathering way of their life. It is necessary to keep moving all the time. As according to However, agriculture makes it possible to store food for use it over a longer period. Hence, there is no need to keep moving constantly. Moreover, the nature of agriculture work made it necessary to stay in one place. So, after learning the agriculture production, it had been made them to settle at one place. As we have studied, in New Stone Age, the Homo sapiens are settled at one place. They are not moving from one place to another place for food or for their livelihood. But in Middle Stone Age and in Old Stone Age, the Homo sapiens were moving from one place to another places to gather the food. Therefore, people established permanent village settlements and lived in them generation after generation. In the next lesson, we shall review the social organization and the culture of these village settlements. So, as by permanent village settlement had resulted to stay at place and to survive their life, which had been resulted them to live in them generation to generation. So, in this lesson, we had seen the different concepts, that is first one, 7.1, shelter. In this point, we had discussed that the Neanderthals lived mainly in caves as the climate in Europe was extremely cold. Also, we had seen they wore leather clothes and used fire to protect themselves from freezing cold. Also, they erected tent inside the caves to keep them warm. Whenever the need arose, they also built huts in the open. After that, all over the world. During this time, the climate was changing and getting warmer. Due to which, the climatic changes, big animals like the mammoths were on the way to extinction, and also they were hunted on a very large scale. That is why the Homo sapiens took up fishing on a large scale. They started hunting small animals like wild boar, deer, mountain goat, and sheep. As a result, the diet of Homo sapiens also changed, and they started roaming from one place in search of food. As per the seasons, they started moving their camps from one place to another places. After that, we had seen the settling of their down the camps. They harvested seasonal food grains, wild grains, and gathered fruits and roots. By using the knowledge and observing, they would find the best season for fishing. By observing, they discovered the best hunting grounds. Also, they made them stay in one place by longer periods. For setting camps, they cleared the jungles by felling the trees. Also, we have seen the village settlement. In that content, we had seen during the New Stone Age, man became producer of food grains. The main characteristics of the culture of the New Stone Age was the beginning of cultivation. Also, the earlier period hunting and gathering was the way of life for which it was necessary to move from one place to another places. But in this period, in New Stone Age, due to agriculture, storing of food and using it for longer period made coming lesson, we are going to see social organization and the culture of these village settlements. So, more detail about the village settlements we are going to see in the coming lesson of chapter number 8. That's all for today. Complete the given exercise and learn the given question and answers. Thank you.